So in this video, I'm going to show you how to start modeling your warehouse. I am situated here in warehouse and warehouse map. This is my current location. The first thing you need to do is you want to create the warehouse, and you do that under administration and then warehouses. I have one already called Gothenburg, so you can create your own here. Create new warehouse. It's as simple as that, and you just give it a name and a code, and then you're good to go. The second thing you need to do is to create a zone. So to do that, you go to administrations and then zones. I already have one called garage, and you can create a new one here and you give it a name. And these XY coordinates, you don't need to bother about those. And then you will have those here, your warehouse and your zone, and you can have multiple ones, and then your aisles. And typically when you get a new system, you will have two locations, A1 and A2, and we have cleared everything else for you. In our case, we're going to model this guy right here. So if you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this scaffolding structure. But you also see that each and every rows in here is different. Now, you can model this in different ways. You can have one location here, one location here, and then you'd have eight different articles to deliver into that location. This is possible, that you can have different articles at the same locations. But in our case, we want to model this a bit smarter. We want to have 8 bins here and 8 bins here, or 8 locations. And then on the top, we only want 1. And then on the third row, we want 4 locations for each here. And on the fourth and fifth, we want 2. So we are going to start with the one that has the most amount of locations, and then we're gonna simply, on the top one, we're just gonna have 1, but we're gonna delete the rest. So we need to start with an aisle that has 8 times 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 40 in X direction and 5 in Y direction. You'll understand in a bit. So to create an aisle, you go to administration and then aisles, and we're going to create a new aisle, and we're going to call it, we're going to put it in the zone garage, and we're going to call it a wall. And we want 40 in the X direction, 40 locations, and in the Y direction, we want 5. And we want to call it wall dash XX with 2 numbers. So the X coordinate becomes 0, 1, 0, 2, and so on. And in the Y coordinate, we want to put it like this. Then when we click preview, we get the full, like 40 in X direction and 5 in Y direction. But remember, the top row, we only wanted to have 1 location for each 8. So we're going to keep 1, and then we're going to delete 7. 3, 6, 7, keep 1 and delete. Keep 1 and then delete. So it's a little bit of work here, but you'll get it once we're done. And we keep that one and then delete the last ones here. And then on the second row, we wanted to have all 40. That's the one that we used as our template. And on the third row, we wanted to have, for each 8, we want to keep 4. So we keep 1, 2, 3, 4, and then delete 4, keep 4 and delete 4. So keep 4, delete 4. And delete the last. And on the two final rows, we wanted to have 2 for each 8. So let's delete sticks, keep two, and keep two and delete six, keep two and delete six, like that, and then we delete the final six. We'll do the same thing on the last row. Like that. Just about done. And then we're going to click create. Now aisle wall has been created, and when we go to the warehouse map, you see at the top row we have one location, on the second row we have eight locations, and on the third row we have four locations, and then another four, of course, and so on. And on the fourth and fifth row we have two locations for every eight. So that's one way of modeling that. I take back this one, you see that one location, eight location, four, two, two, and so on. So that's one way of modeling it, and now we can keep eight different articles in each of and every one of those bins. So one final thing is that if you want to print barcodes for each of the locations, you go to administrations and then locations, and then you have this location labels. So you can select one or all of them and click location label, and then you get them printed. So we don't want the first two. I'll multi-select, and then I'll just uncheck these ones. And then this is what we just created, the wall aisle, and then we can get locations for all of those by clicking this button, and then you get the PDF with locations, and then you can just print it and you're ready to go with scanning on your different locations. So that's it for this video. Thank you.